Eric Backer, the naturopath, talking about enzymes. If you haven't seen the other videos in the series, please watch this whole series. You're going to get a lot of good information out of this, especially if you've had all kinds of issues like weight issues, fatigue, brain fog, can't sleep properly. You know, it's very important to watch this. Simple stuff, basic stuff works the best. We're talking today about lactose and lactase, you know, and enzymes and lactase deficiency. So the question was, can enzyme deficiency cause lactose intolerance? Absolutely. So enzymes often end in the ASE or A's, you know, xylanase and, you know, just weird names like that. So lactase is an enzyme that's produced in the small bowel that breaks down a sugar found in milk called lactose. So lactose intolerance, let's talk about that. The prevalence is anywhere from 5% up to 100%, depending on the type of person you are, where you live, you know, genetics. Lots of factors will account for that. If we look at indigenous peoples like the American Indian, for example, the Aboriginal person from Australia, the Māori people from New Zealand, I would take it Hawaiian people, that, you know, people particularly from Indo-Pacific region, they have a very big problem when it comes to lactose. People didn't usually have cows in these islands, you know. I mean, I didn't really see cows walking around when I was in Tahiti when I was a kid. The Maori didn't really have cows here. That's just not an animal, you know, that featured in their culture. Asian people, you know, Japanese don't usually have a lot of cows walking around. They don't drink glasses of milk all the time. So if you haven't had milk, you know, for many, many generations, you haven't really got a need for building powerful levels of lactase in your small bowel. So, you know, genetically that will wane. If we look at northwestern Europe, however, around, particularly around, you know, I think it's the Red Sea, is it the Red Sea or one of these areas there, there's a very low incidence of the dairy intolerance, because these people had goats, they had cows, they herded them, you know, and they looked after dairy. So, and again, genetically, they have got a much higher ability to handle that particular milk sugar and break it down. So the signs and symptoms of lactose intolerance are usually bloating and cramping. And then that, you know, you get this diarrhea, this urgency to go to the bathroom. And that can happen 30 minutes up to 1 hour or a little bit after an hour after you've had particularly milk or a dairy product like that. So sure, you can go to the health food shop and get little drops, you know, lactase drops and stuff like that. But also bacteria are linked up, you know, with the ability for the body to break down lactose properly. So studies have also shown that people with very good balanced microbiome with small levels of yeast, with very good levels of beneficial bacteria, they tend to have a better fermentation and digestion of carbohydrates, including sugars like lactose. So their ability to handle lactose is far greater than a person who's got a trashed gut. It's not going to work properly with those people. So it's important to understand with healthy digestive system comes a healthy ability to digest many different types, you know, to ferment and break these sugars and carbohydrates down properly. So what do you do when you've got lactose intolerance? Well, if you really want to know if you've got it, avoid cow's milk, particularly any type of cow's milk, you know, avoid those milks. You can get A2 milk, you know, which is, no, actually A2 I'll talk about later. That's got more to do with the allergy response. So you can get milks that, you know, that are lactose free and stuff like this, but I wouldn't go and eating or drinking modified foods. I don't think they're good to eat. So if you want to know if you've got a lactose problem, just stop milk for 14 days and then start having small amounts to see if you get the cramping or bloating back again. And if you do, my suggestion is to do a stool test, a comprehensive one, find out what state the gut's in, improve it, but don't strictly 100% avoid milk. You may even want to have a tiny little bit here or there, because if you do that, you're going to really create a big challenge kind of problem down the track. So work on the gut, and that will really improve your ability to, you know, break all kinds of foods down. Lactose intolerant people vary from mild to extreme. So you may be able to tolerate certain types of cheeses like goat's cheese or like, you know, kefir or like yogurt or buttermilk. So these foods may be more acceptable for your gut than just hardcore milk. You may also find raw milk, organic, grass-fed milk in small quantities may be fine. But when you get that stuff in plastic bottles, you know, from factories, it may be totally not fine. So before you jump on the bandwagon and say, oh, I can't tolerate milk and la, 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 you may find that little bits here or there may be perfectly fine. And then you're going to get the cow police and the milk police coming in saying, milk's designed for calves, you know, for baby animals, and we shouldn't be drinking that. Cauliflowers are designed for cauliflowers. Tomatoes are designed for birds. I mean, you could make all these crazy statements if you want. But people have been consuming dairy products for thousands and thousands of years. So again, don't become very binary and black and white about any food in your life. Just think, how does food affect my gut? You know, what benefits do I get from the food? How much has it been doctored or chopped up or messed with by people? If you have raw milk from a cow on, you know, fed good food, a good pasture, low stress, it's a fantastic food for the body in small quantities, especially if you make buttermilk from this or take that milk and create a good yogurt with it. So just be careful not to become the police. Thanks for tuning in.